Hello, everyone, and welcome to this 41st episode of 5 Minutes with NY Ike. I am Isaac Sacolick, or NY Ike on Twitter. And in this episode, we're going to be talking about the role of the Agile Delivery Manager, the person guiding multiple Agile teams working on a product or maybe working on a program, trying to get coordinated releases out, improve quality, and make sure we get to delighted customers. Let's get started. So first, let's talk about a single Agile team. And most people practicing Scrum know who a product owner or a team or tech lead are. There are also roles of the Scrum Master. In some groups, they also assign a business analyst. And you can see I've covered some of these roles in previous episodes of 5 Minutes with NY Ike. Now, when we start grouping multiple teams together into an organization, specifically when we're working on a common product or group of products and platforms, then we start to think about how we have multiple teams working on different parts of the agenda and how they collaborate. Now, I've covered some of this in other episodes of 5 Minutes with NY Ike when I've talked about the role of the PMO and the role of program management. I've also talked about the role of product manager and what a product manager is doing with product owners and working with multiple teams. But this is the episode where I'm really talking about the role of the delivery manager. So let's compare the role of the delivery manager with the role of the product manager. And I think of the product manager as someone most aligned with defining the scope, the vision, who the customers are, what problems we're solving for. So in classic project management, we think of product owners and managers really owning the scope and the end user and that voice. When I think about the delivery manager, that person is most responsible for delivering on time and delivering to quality and standards. And obviously, that's going to create some conflicts at time, but we need people accountable for handling both. And really what the Agile process is trying to do through a collaboration around teamwork, around culture, around principles, is how do we transform and how do we plan so that these two individuals and these teams can work on delivering a great product or platform or program and also hitting dates and quality and standards at the same time. So now let's dive deeper into the role of the Agile Delivery Manager. Now we know their scope and who they're collaborating with when working with multiple Agile teams. So when I think about the role of the Agile Delivery Manager, I'm really starting with the perspective of releases. How do multiple teams coordinate on delivering a quality release, whether you're working on products or platforms or programs? And in the STAR CIO Agile planning programs, we take features through the process that you're seeing here. We're always planning every single sprint. We're estimating, we're writing stories. We're going into delivery mode where we're actually making sure that we can commit and review our stories. We're then deploying them through testing and deployment automations. And then of course, we're managing feedback. So this is the overall process. The delivery manager is working with team leads, scrum masters, and then their teams to be able to execute to. So let's break down what this means for the delivery manager. And it starts with owning the responsibility of how many teams, who is assigned to the teams, and what are they most responsible for. I like delivery managers who are somewhat technical, right? Because we want teams to fit the two pizza-sized rule. I'll talk more about that in my blog post around this one. But we also want to make sure that there's reasonable separation of duties, that there's minimal conflicts between our teams. And that takes a little bit of knowledge of the architecture and team skills and who to put on what team to be most successful. I want those teams to be self-organizing, but also following standards, right? If I'm having multiple teams, having everybody do their own thing in terms of tools and in terms of process will lead to chaos. So where a delivery manager steps in is to figure out and work with these teams, where following standards, what standards to create, and how to get people aligned to them. When I think about the Agile process itself, right? There are certain times when a delivery manager is going to be asked, or teams are going to be asked, for a forecast. What do we think should go into our roadmap over the next 6 months? And that requires understanding how well teams are releasing, how much productivity you're getting out of them. And I trust the delivery manager's instincts when I have to go beyond a quarter worth or 3 months worth of forecasting and start projecting what my releases are. I'm also expecting my delivery manager to help me prioritize risks, right? I want to hear all the technical debt, all the defects, all the issues coming from my teams, but I expect my delivery manager to be able to prioritize them. I want my teams following architecture standards. I want them working on technical debt. I want to see a healthy prioritization of innovation, whether it's POC work or research or learning or spikes, just so that the team continues to craft what they're doing. I want to make sure also the team is realigned when required to handle production issues. So when there is a production issue, I prefer not calling it all hands on deck. I prefer going to the delivery manager and the team leads and saying, who needs to be most involved in handling this production issue? And how important is it that we address features and defects together to ensure reliable releases? Finally, when you think about learning and mentorship, we have a bunch of team leads working with these agile teams. The person most responsible for guiding these team leads, mentoring them, ensuring that they're constantly learning is the delivery manager. So obviously a very important role. I like to call it the CTO for a channel of work, often working with between 2 and as many as 6, but often around 3 or 4 teams. And this is how you scale the culture and practices of an agile organization. Thank you for watching this episode of 5 Minutes with NY Ike. You can get the corresponding you can sign up for the newsletter at starcio.com/5nyike/ep41. I hope you'll sign up for the newsletter and sign up and subscribe to this channel. Have a great day. We have some more work coming later this quarter around roles and teams around Agile, and I hope you are successful working with your Agile organizations. Have a great day.